Now I would like to move on and discuss a series of paintings I did from a trip that Susan and I took to China in May of 2006. We were living in Florence at the time. We had an opportunity to take a five-week trip to China, and we started in the imperial city of Beijing, formerly known as Peking. It's the capital of the People's Republic of China. It's actually one of the second, it's only the second largest city in China. It's over 21 million people, but it is the cultural, educational, and political center of the Chinese government and of China, and it's over 3,000 years old. It's a very incredibly interesting place. There are seven UNESCO World Heritage Sites, including the Forbidden City, the Temple of Heaven, the Summer Palace, the Ming Tombs, the site of the Peking Man, the first archaeological discovered man about something like 2,000 years ago, the Grand Canal, and of course the Great Wall. Now we're looking at two paintings I did of the Great Wall near Mutianyu, which is about 40 miles from Beijing. And a little bit of a background on the Great Wall. It's a secret, or it's a series of fortifications that were built across the older historical boundaries of the northern China to protect against the ancient imperial armies of Eurasia. Over the years, as they became built throughout the country, they were also fortifications that separated different dynasties. And there's actually no real formal definition of the Great Wall, because it's sort of multiple stretches of ramparts and trenches and ditches and so forth. Probably the most famous section is the wall that was built, started to be built in the Qi, that's Qi dynasty, in 550 to 700 BC, but then it was fortified and rebuilt by the Ming dynasty in the Ming dynasty wall is about 5,500 miles, and this is sort of the part of the end of it in Mutianyu. And so I did two paintings of the Great Wall, as we can see here. And the first one on the top is 24 by 32 inches. And I thought that this was a great composition in the sense that the wall is something in the painting that starts right up at the top, comes over to the right, down across the middle, and then opens up to the viewer in the front. And the same, it's basically the same composition for both paintings. Interesting, in order to get to Mutianyu from Beijing, it's a little scary. I mentioned it's about 40 miles, but the first part of the, most part of the journey is in a car, but then you get to the base of the mountain, and you have to get on a little cable car, which is more frightening than the drive from Beijing. But once we got there, it was just an experience we'll never forget. We had a wonderful guide, this brilliant Chinese woman named Amanda, who gave us a big history of what the walls were. There are basically fortifications and watchtowers, as you can see. This section has 22 watchtowers. There's one in the middle. And this also, in Mutianyu, sort of goes through the countryside. It's like 90% forest. But it was just to walk this and listen to the people talk about the history was just something. So I did the paintings. I didn't really have my sketchbook with me. So most of the work I did from Beijing and Mutianyu was from photographs. This particular scene, again, I think the background, if you look at in both paintings, I think I pretty much talk about them at the same time, because the first one was, as I mentioned, 24 by 32, and it gave me the courage to do the bigger one, which is 60 by 72. In both, the trees, the forest, the mountains in the background are fairly realistic, whereas on the right side of the wall, and particularly in the bottom one, the colors are quite more vibrant, much brighter, a lot more fun. Incidentally, the wall itself is not this color. I have a painting on the next screen, which is more realistic. But when I was back in Florence, I started out with the base color on the 24 by 32, but I decided that I'd make it more colorful, and I sort of made it Tuscan oriented, and like the Tuscan bricks, and I guess that's just the effect of working in Tuscany. But again, the same sort of divergence of the very, very bright colors, and particularly in the large painting, they're a lot more vibrant, but the background on the large painting is pretty similar to the background on the top painting. There's a tremendous amount of bright colors, sort of happy colors, in the foreground, in the middle of the bottom painting. And it's kind of interesting, the art historian and author and TV star, Sister Wendy Beckett, started following my work in 2002, as I've mentioned before. And then in 2006, she actually made a visit to my studio in Florence. And we picked her up at the train station. We was traveling to two priests, and we had my friend David Tweed in his van. And as soon as she got in the van, she started to say, "Well, I'm a little apprehensive about looking at your Chinese paintings," which I had basically just started. And she had been following my Tuscan work for about 4 years. And she said that. She said, "I so love your Tuscan paintings." So I said, "Well, this is going to be a test to myself." Because when we walk in my studio on the Ponte Vecchio, it was on the top floor of a four-story building. This painting, the large one, was on the wall because I was painting it. And it wasn't quite done. But when you walked in the studio, which is kind of small, this hit you as soon as you walked in. And as soon as Sister Wendy saw it, she just looked at it, took a deep breath, and said, "This, William, is an extraordinary painting." And that made me feel very good and relieved, because I was anticipating she might not like it as well as the Tuscan paintings. But at any rate, that was a great compliment from her. Again, big one, 60 by 72. I still have this in my studio in Florida. It's one of our favorite paintings. The smaller version, the 24 by 32, was purchased by Robert and Catherine Carr of Sarasota, Florida. Now on to the next screen. Now this is the other painting that I was referring to that is more realistic as far as the colors go. Now the composition is pretty much the same, but it's a little, we were further down on the wall and I was actually walking out in the field and I was taking some photographs. This painting is actually from one of my photographs. And I had I love this little burrow here just on the tree, kind of relaxing. The colors in the background, as you can see, are pretty similar to the other paintings, but the wall itself is very realistic. This is sort of the color of the beige, kind of boring color. And again, it's the same curvature coming down from the top of the canvas all the way across the middle and opening in the middle, but it doesn't go as far down as the others because I've got these beautiful little trees. These were actually fairly accurate in the colors of the trees, and the dirt and the sand is pretty realistic. It was something I wanted to do after exaggerating it. In fact, if you can see the colors down from the watchtower in the middle of the painting, they're very subdued as opposed to the colors in the other painting. But once again, a very realistic view. And this is, you'll probably see a lot of views of or similar views of the other painting, but this is totally unique in my opinion. It's very different. I've never quite seen anything quite like it. And I do have this painting is a vertical 24 by 32. And we have this in my studio in Florence, Italy. Okay, this concludes my discussion of the paintings I did of the Great Wall at Mutanyu, which is near the Imperial City of Beijing. Thank you.